Hey guys, today we're going to be lashing the valves on my small block Chevy. So last season we were working on the engine and we're doing a bunch of stuff. So test running the engine again, cleaning up some more wiring, had to reseal parts on the carburetor, and I highly recommend you guys always run some sort of exhaust to make it quiet. Actually make it quieter than you intend because you really want to listen to the engine. So we've noticed that when we would touch the top of the rockers, even listening to it, it was noisy. We noticed that the valve train was actually hitting the valve cover. So we bought a new valve cover which had way more clearance, and again it was still making noise. And we checked the rockers here, and we noticed that they're in some positions they're actually really loose, so we have to lash them. So what's basically happening in our engine? So let's do a little example. Let's pretend this is our lifter and this is our push rod and this is your cam lobe. So what I'm experiencing in the truck is if the lifter and the push rod are kind of on a incline position on the cam lobe, it feels tight. However, when it's on the bottom or the heel of the cam lobe, we now have play. So in typical instruction, what they want you to do is they want you to get the cam for each cylinder, and then whether it's intake or exhaust, get each one into this position in order to make our valve lash to zero. So this is basically how a cam works. It's the brain of it, of the engine. It basically tells when to open and close the valves depending on what's going on. I also want to mention when we're doing this procedure, the hydraulic lifters are not pumped up with oil. Whenever working on an engine, we're going to make sure we disconnect the negative terminal off the battery. Now we're going to go ahead and remove our bolts that hold on our valve cover. Now, before starting this process, this part might depend on what kind of hardware you have. So these have a poly lock inside. These are ComCam parts. So we're going to have to loosen off all of these inside first before we start the process. And then when we're done, then we can go ahead and retighten them. Referencing our service manual, we can see here how they set the lash. So they're just saying to rotate each push rod until it's tight. And we're basically removing the play because we can't twist it anymore. So let's recap what the manual is saying. So what they want you to achieve is getting to the bottom of each cam lobe and removing the play. So as you're twisting it, you feel some friction and it stops spinning. But what we're going to be doing is we're going to be tightening it no matter where it is on the cam lobe. So as it eventually gets to here, you'll remove the play, you'll get the zero lash. And then as you keep moving it around, when you reinspect this push rod, it's going to feel pretty much the same. So this is the beauty about this particular technique from Ellison Empire is we don't necessarily have to figure out when we're at the heel because we're tightening it all over the cam lobe, including right here, it's going to be tight. So it doesn't matter because you are going to get to this point and you're going to do two revolutions. So you're pretty much ensuring that you're hitting zero lash. So I'm not an engine builder, but these engines are pretty simple. Now, I want to give full credit to Ellison Empire. I'm going to put their channel and also the original video in the description below because he came up with the easiest way to set valve lash. Typically, when you read the manuals, they're going to say, okay, start cylinder one, go to top dead center, and then go to either the intake or the exhaust valve, and that's how you have to get it to the heel, the bottom of the cam lobe. So here's our intake, here's our exhaust, and then you need to tighten it down and remove the play and then move on to the next cylinder, and you're going all over the engine. And he developed a way which makes so much sense that it doesn't matter where you start, it's easy to check. So he starts lashing it right away. So what we do is we twist the push rod. I'm going to do it over here because you can see it on camera, but we're going to start. I'm actually going to start over here, but for videoing's sake, so I can feel this twist. So I'm gonna keep rotating, I'm gonna keep tightening it until we remove that play. So now I remove the play out of it, and then I'm gonna go to the next one. So this one rotates, a little bit loose, but now I've removed the play. And I'm gonna keep going around the entire engine. So they recommend to do 2 revolutions of the engine, so we're gonna do that. So here's an example, so you see, you tighten these up, they don't move at all, it doesn't move here, doesn't move here. This one moves quite a bit. I can twist it easily. We're not moving it much, just a little bit at a time. There, that tightened it up right there on that one. And just keep on going. Single valve that we can in this position, we are going to turn it. So I highly recommend you do this before you put the engine into the vehicle if you can. So we're going to rotate it, and we're just going to get a quarter turn out of it, and then do the process all over again. Now after rotating the engine again, as we're getting closer to the heel of the cam, this one's still tight, but all of these ones are loose. These are tight. Well, this one back here is loose. So it's changing. Like when we first tightened up, they're all tight. We've moved it around. But the cool thing is, like, I have no idea what position they are in. Like, unless I can actually see the rocker go all the way up or down, I don't really. They're all kind of even right now. I have no idea what position they are on the cam, and it doesn't matter because we're just tightening up in slow increments. And it's just like the littlest turn will get it tight. Just keep on going. So this is the crank pulley, and this is where, well, this is the dampener, and then here's the crank pulley over here. And this is how we're going to be rotating the engine. Remember, we have to do this several times. So what I do is I'm going to put a piece of masking tape here, and as I crank it, I'm going to watch it go a quarter turn. So remember, you want to get two full rotations out of the engine. So we want to keep track of how many times we're turning it over as we keep tightening up those valves. For me, this made it a little bit easier. So as it goes a quarter, I will peel off the tape, put it back here, go work the valves, go a quarter, pull up the tape, move it back here. This keeps me on track. Comp Cams also has a really good video where basically they simplify it as well, where they have, if you have the intake all the way down and then the exhaust will be all the way up or vice versa, and then afterwards they would take a feeler gauge. This isn't in the correct position, but they would take a feeler gauge between the roller here and the valve spring, and that's how they would set their valve lash. So What I like about this particular way, like I've mentioned so many times before, is it really takes out the guesswork. So for a novice like me who is trying to get this right, and not really have to keep track of where I am, this makes my life a lot easier how I'm going about through this. So now you've got zero lash on here, and depending on how you set up how much lash there is or how much clearance there is for it, that can affect how your engine is going to run. So because we just want to get this just to make it run properly and not have any issues, have the vehicle start up right away and have a good idle as soon as possible. Now that we've made sure, and we've gone through the engine a few times, we have no play going on these push rods. What I'm going to do is I'm using a breaker bar because it has an angle and it's easy for me to go around. So I'm going to go through all of them on both sides and I'm going to turn these 3/4 of a turn and then that's it. Now, depending on how much room you have, I have more room out here. So I can start here and then do a quarter, and then do a quarter. That will give me my 3/4, and then I can do that across all of them. So what I like about this one's perfect. It clears my air cleaner and everything. So I can go ahead and do that for every single one. Okay, finish all our 3/4 turns. So I'm just going in each of these, rechecking my tightness. I already tightened these beforehand, but I want to make sure that all these are all snugged up. Now we go ahead and put on our valve cover, inspecting that there's no debris in there. I put new gloves on as well. And these gaskets are always fun to work with. One, two. Test it, go ahead and hook up our battery and give it a good charge. Let's go ahead and test it. Quiet, so we used to hear a lot of ticking out of here. Good fuel pressure. Okay, took off the valve cover again after running it to see what we got going on after the lifters have pumped up a bit. It's 5W30 in this truck right now. I'm probably going to step it up to a 5W40 synthetic. Doing research, seems that hydraulic lifters do prefer 40 weight in them. I can refer to my other video where I found documentation on this. But compared to before, like, yeah, there's a little bit of play. But before, it was like rattling loose so much when the valve was released all the way, and we've pretty much removed all that. So I'm very happy with how this turned out. Well, there you guys have it. It runs really well. I know some people really prefer just checking for lateral movement. You'll see a bunch of people, they'll just check for that and then they'll do
do the quarter turn, and then they'll snug that posi lock right away. We did it the other way, where we're checking for play as soon as we feel tension, go around the whole thing until it feels the same all the way around, and we did the three-quarter turn. But what I can say is, the way this truck used to be, it would take a long time. It would crank for a while. Even if I had it warmed up for a bit, it go, and then it would fire up. You notice now, it's literally one turnover and it fires up right away. The other thing I noticed was the garage, even though we have exhaust coming out, it kind of wafts back into the garage because we're not pushing the truck out all the way. There'd be a lot of unburned fuel. And your eyes would get watery, basically, if this thing was idling for too long. What I noticed was, after we shut it off, it didn't really smell that bad in here. So right away, it warms up a lot quicker in terms of, once it's warm, it idles on its own, doesn't fall on its face. Before, I'd have to baby it for almost 10 minutes and just, play with the throttle until it idles. Now it's down to 5. It doesn't stink nearly as bad, and it cranks over way quicker. So just from anecdotal experience, doing it this way, my truck is running significantly better now. So, I think it works.